Organized labor in all its glory. What do you think?
It seems rather disorganized to me. I keep hearing the word strike.
Strike? No, no. See, strike would be illegal. What you do is you cram 50 guys into one room, and you figure out who's going to be the first to come down with the flu. Cough, cough. Well, what do you know? They all have the flu now, the blue flu. So, what appears to be a strike is not actually a strike at all. It's just 50 guys who can't wait to get home and shake hands with the unemployed. Would you mind, please?
I'd be honored.
Detectives Division.
Squad room?
Yes.
Yes, sir. You'll have to calm down. And can you tell me your name, please? Henry. Henry. Do you have a last name, Henry? No, I'm not trying to be inquisitive.
This offer is insulting! They're laughing at us! We deserve respect!
I am not a police officer! I am a man!
An impossible situation. You can't be expected to know everything. No, I think you should sit down with your wife. I think you should talk to her, and I think you should listen to her. No, 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 Henry. I am not suggesting that your wife is always right, but in this case, she may well be. Yes. Well, yes, I do believe that a 3/16 ratchet head wrench is exactly what's called for. Yes, I am Canadian. It's my pleasure, and, thank you kindly.
What do you think you're doing?
People are calling for help.
But you don't work here, Fraser. We do. We'll handle it. Come on, hand scrape. Chicago PD, Area 7 Detective Division.
Hi. Hi. You work here?
Yeah, one of the very few.
Yeah, I'm Janet Morris. I'm in from Montana. And,
Hey, 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 I told you guys to wait in the truck. Robbie!
Your name, sir? Bob.
Let's see what's in this room.
How do you spell that?
Honey, Annie, can you tell your sister not to be scared, please?
Well, there's nothing to be scared about until the swamp monster eats your head.
Mommy!
Thanks a lot. Sorry about this.
No way, a Mountie.
Pretty cute, actually.
Yeah, if you're into pain. Annie, honey, will you go and get your brother for me, sweetheart, please?
They got a candy machine.
Jeez. Just give me a sec, will you? Sorry. Kids, hey, hey, hey.
Now, you gotta do what you think is
sorry,
right.
Excuse me.
But if you happen to wake up tomorrow feeling not so good,
sorry.
Feel free to call in and exercise your right.
Gun, freeze!
Hi, guys. A little touchy today?
Honey, I want to go back to the truck.
Okay, hon.
Mom, can I have 50 cents for the candy machine?
In a minute, sweetheart. Mom's a little busy right now.
Gentlemen, please. I'm sure she has a legitimate reason for having this weapon.
Excuse me. Want to get the gun out of my face? We can all relax with the gun action. What are you, Arnold Schwarzenegger?
She does have a legitimate reason. She's a bounty hunter.
Anybody got a problem with that?
We'll be right back.
gonna be a minute, okay? So everybody don't move a muscle and be good, right? Okay?
So this is all the paperwork?
Yeah. It's Bradley Torrance. Charges for felony weapons possession, skipped out on $25,000 bail. I'm in the employ of Hector J. Jones, bail bondsman, Billing, Montana. And so you've got a copy of everything, including the registration for my gun.
Guns.
Yeah.
Guns.
Just a few?
Bounty hunter? You're a bounty hunter? As in, wanted dead or alive?
Dead or alive, seriously injured, whatever. Okay, give me back the gum. No, we had a deal here. Where's your sister? Annie?
Over here.
Sweetheart, can you just help me out here with the kids for a minute?
Hey, you're the mother.
I know that I'm the mother.
Sorry. It's just that firearms accounted for 39,595 American deaths last year. 1,441 of them were accidental.
And less than half of 1% involved licensed professionals, and there were circumstances in each of those cases.
True enough.
But thanks.
Fraser, can I have a word with you?
Excuse me.
So this is really cool. Have you always been a bounty hunter?
Nah. You know, I started out in construction, and then I worked the rigs for a while, and I did a little bit of trick riding in the rodeo.
Those kids are immature.
Well, they're children, right?
Trick riding? Wow, that must have been...
It's hard on your back.
Yeah.
And you know, it's murder on the kids. These, the hours,
right.
You know, they're just grueling. So I thought bounty hunting. The money's good, you can set your own hours, get a little time off to spend with the kids. Oh! Got it, thanks.
Good. Good catch.
Thanks. You know, could you run a quick plate for me before I go?
You want me to run a plate?
Yeah, could you run a plate?
You mean like a dinner plate?
Is he really a cop?
Yes, actually, he is. Unfortunately, you've stepped into the middle of labor unrest.
Blue flu.
Yeah, we're all sick, very sick. And as you can see, our hands are full, very full.
And so you can't run a plate for me?
No.
That's great. That's really great. I really appreciate the professional support here and the, forget it, just forget it. It's okay, I'm fine. I can do it myself. Come on, kids. Let's go. We're out of here. Annie, come on, honey. A little smile on your face, please. Just a little cooperation. Come on.
Ma'am. Ma'am?
What?
Your weapon.
Damn it.
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm not getting enough sleep.
Triple! What? Look, I can't break ranks on this.
Understood.
No, I can't. Look, Fraser, I can't.
Well, I heard you, Ray. I understand.
I don't need the help, you know. I like working alone.
Well, actually, I'm not a licensed peace officer in this jurisdiction.
You're not?
No, I'm afraid not.
Well, then what the hell good are you?
Well, I thought perhaps I could help look after your children.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ace.
Well, yeah, okay, you could do that.
Done.
I'm just gonna warn you, though, if you're gonna be hanging around, I got a bit of a temper.
Well, people say the same thing about me.
Really?
No.
Kind of a long way from home, aren't you?
As are you.
Yeah, as am I.
You're sitting on Toad.
Am I? Oh, dear. Oh, well, so I am.
Thanks.
Did I hurt him?
You can't hurt him. He's stuffed.
Bozo.
Robbie.
Oh, he does have a point. Dave, do you mind?
Friends really easy.
Well, that's an important ability to have in life.
Sure, just so she can find stuff out.
Well, that's important too.
Bozo.
You're a bozo.
He's a bozo.
You know something? I think we're all bozos.
Okay, I got you some mints. So before you start hollering that they're not up to the Holiday Inn standards, just want you to know that they were all they had.
Thank you kinda.
Well, that was a fugitive's girlfriend. Ex-girlfriend, actually, knew her in Montana.
Has he contacted her here?
Mm-hmm. Got an address.
Well, before we visit him, I wonder if I could make one suggestion.
A potential babysitter.
So they sit right there? The criminals? They sit right there?
Yeah, and then we ask them questions, like, if somebody got whacked, we go, you whacked that guy?
And if they don't cooperate, do you yell at them?
Yell at them? Yeah, sometimes.
You must have kids.
In here? Not that often.
No, I mean you. You got kids.
Oh, me? No, I wanted kids, but my wife didn't, so.
So you got a bad guy. Say you caught him. And he's a bad guy. So you take your handcuffs and you put them on the back of his wrists?
Yeah, like that, right. No.
Okay, and then you get the bad guy. And you get him in a corner?
Yeah, sometimes we do that.
Then you lock the bad guy up.
Yes, we do that once in a while, but then we let him go, so. Hey, kids, keys. Hey, that's not buddies.
Okay, let's see what else there's to do.
I hate you.
Nobody home.
No one's answering.
Oh, we'd hear him breathing if he were in there.
True enough. Maybe we can find a manager who'll let us in.
Well, we could do that, sure, but why bother him?
How long have you been doing this kind of work?
Not long. Why do you ask?
You seem to have a natural aptitude for it.
Well, I grew up in Montana. And, my dad was taking me hunting with him by the time I was 3. You know, I gotta tell you that there is not a lot of difference between bear hunting and hunting bill jumpers.
Well, I suppose not. Well, I find the scent trails much more useful with bear.
Well, that's true. And the scat's more informative.
Oh, well, scat in a city was virtually useless.
Especially in the winter.
I know. Well, everything's... How much do you know about this man that you're hunting?
Enough.
Is he dangerous?
Not particularly. $300.
Are you planning on taking that?
You have a problem with that?
Well, ordinarily, yes, I have a problem with theft.
Well, sure. But, this is evidence.
Oh.
Of the fact that he has $300. I don't usually do this. But it just means the kids and I won't have to spend another night in the truck.
I understand.
Hold it, sweetheart!
Hey, don't shoot.
Ride's over.
We can cut some sort of a deal, right? Down. Huh.
Should we do something?
What?
About the bad guys?
Oh, my bad guys.
Get out of here!
Torrance!
Get out of here!
You rotten scumbag!
You're gonna get us killed!
I couldn't get a grip on that wheel.
Well, I was holding a shotgun.
Yeah, but I could have spun him out.
I could have blown out his tires.
This is not some Penny Annie hood here. This smells like the real deal. So I'm thinking maybe there's something you forgot to tell us.
Oh, I didn't realize you were working on the case. But, you know, since you asked, no. Nothing I forgot to tell you. It's Bradley Torrance, small-time slimeball chiseler, pure and simple.
Small-time guy with big-time guns chasing him.
I don't know. Maybe it was mistaken identity.
Well, that seems unlikely, given the probability that the men in question followed us to Torrance.
What?
Well, I noticed them behind us a couple of times when you were driving.
You might have mentioned that.
Well, I assumed you were aware of them.
Yeah, maybe I was and maybe I wasn't, but, you know, those assumptions can be dangerous.
You know, you're quite right. I stand corrected.
No. I should have noticed.
Well, no,
listen to you two. You need professional help.
Psychiatric?
No, cop help.
Well, hey, I tried.
Yeah, but I told you, we're in the middle of something here.
Yeah, so you keep saying.
Look, I don't like harebakes shooting up the city any more than you do.
Excuse me, with all due respect to your collective illness, you think I might be able to find a detective who'll work on an actual crime?
Keep it real, man. Francesca, you get this shotgun up to forensics, see if you can get some prints or something off it.
I'm on the phone.
I know you're on the phone. After you get off the phone, hey. That's the description of the shooters. I want that out to all the beat cars. Make copies of that, okay?
Well, we have plenty of cases at our desks already which deserve our unfocused, undivided attention.
Hey, no jumping the line.
Look, I'm gonna have to deal with this later, okay?
Yeah, sure. Well, that's fine.
I'm sorry.
No, you've been a terrific help. I should go. Okay, come on, kids, saddle up. Let's go find ourselves a motel. I don't believe it.
What?
It's gone. That scumbag took it. The $300.
Mommy,
he took
I'm
it.
Tired.
Okay, honey. Come on. Can you recommend a good parking garage? Preferably one that doesn't get too much morning sun.
Constable Turnbull?
Wow!
Ah, sir.
Constable, this is Janet Morse. These are her children, Annie, Robbie, Sue.
Hello.
And they will be sleeping here tonight.
Oh.
I want to sleep up there.
Hey.
No. It's just that nobody can sleep up there. It's the queen's bedroom.
The queen sleeps here?
Oh, she could. Whenever she's in Chicago, the regal suite will always be ready for her.
But she's never actually slept there.
No.
Princess Di?
No.
Fergie?
No.
Has anyone slept there?
Oh, yes, indeed he do. The chairman of the beef marketing board, huh?
I have some bedding in the...
Oh, Bobby Orr slept here once. And Katie Lang. But not at the same time for obvious reasons.
You live here?
Yes. Well, till I find something more permanent, which I imagine will be pretty much...
Like this?
Yes, I suppose so.
Well, you don't need much.
No.
It's very peaceful.
Hey, you kids, come here. Ow, that's smart.
Excuse me.
I want a smack for someone your size.
Suzanne?
Uh-oh, here comes Mom. Now you gotta get it.
Minute of your time, son. I don't know. They said that apple would last longer, gives off a pleasant aroma, and that may well be true, but I'll tell you this much, son. It's damn difficult to get that stuff to burn.
What do you want, Dad?
Interesting woman.
Yes, she is.
Nice kids.
What are you trying to suggest?
I'm not suggesting anything, son. Just that lately, I've been thinking a lot about grandchildren.
Grandchildren?
Yeah, well, you know, I'm getting on.
Getting on? You're Deb.
Yes, I am. And in death, I'm learning to appreciate the importance of family. All of those great times we had together, you know?
Dad, Mom and I saw you about once every 16 weeks. And sometimes then you slept out with the dogs.
Well, there's always a good reason, son. No. My mind is hearkening back to those special times. You know, all of those great family dinners.
We never had family dinners.
Well, God willing, someone will die before Christmas and I'll have them around for dinner. Maybe your cousins, Douglas and Dwayne, they were always fun. In the meantime, making a close appraisal of this girl, Janet. She'd be good for you. She's sturdy.
Sturdy? Yeah. Great advice, Dad. Really. Top drawer. Thank you.
That's all right, son. Door's always ajar.
Now, I thought we discussed this. Absolutely no going upstairs.
Constable, have you seen Ms. Morris? All right, listen, just continue doing what you're doing just continue doing it.
But, sir...
Good man.
Okay, I've got an idea. I'm gonna read you a classic story, Gulliver's Travels. It's a story about a man who travels around the world having adventures.
Like our dad?
Is your dad a giant? Oh, ow!
Mom!
I found this on a boot in his closet. I believe the mixture to be composed of mud, rubbing alcohol, straw, and horse sweat.
I find that all very interesting, Fraser.
Well, my conclusion is that it comes from a nearby stables. Now, Janet, or Ms. Morris, was with me when I found it, so I believe that she will be at the stables even as we speak.
You overstand my position on this, Fraser. I cannot break ranks on this.
No, I understand this completely. So what I was hoping is that we could explore the possibility of pay duty as, say, a supplement to your income. It's my understanding that it's common practice for many police officers to lend their services in areas, say, such as crowd control or additional security.
Yeah, well, but...
Right. So, how much would it cost me to hire you to accompany me?
To the stables.
Correct.
50.
40.
30.
20.
Done.
Lilliputians. Lilliputians are little tiny people that make Gulliver look like a giant.
Like you?
Well, suppose I am kind of tall.
He's a real bozo. Yeah, like a 19. Just do what I said, okay? Okay, whatever.
What?
Jesus.
Sorry.
Kids okay?
Yeah, they're fine.
Oh, good. Sorry to duck out like that.
Oh, it's all right.
Look, I don't mean to interrupt, but is he here?
Yeah, head groom said she hired a new guy about 4 months ago. Different name, but it sounds like him.
Torrance, we're here to help.
Stop, Chicago PD!
Some people you just can't help.
You have beautiful children.
They're rats. But, you know, when you see them like this, you remember why you really wanted them.
You're lucky.
Yeah, I am. You know, it's really nice of you to do this.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
You mean that?
Yes.
You miss home?
Yes. You?
Oh, yes. We got a place.
Mm-hmm. Fortitude Bay. It's a 4-day hike in from Chilkoot Pass. It's very peaceful. Well, once you get past the lava springs and the pole cats, the poisonous tundra beetles. You?
Yeah, I do.
Here, let me, I'll move.
I got a cabin just by a waterfall, outside Whitefish. You know, built it myself. It's a pretty little place, but I don't get up much there anymore.
It's very easy to become disconnected.
That's right, it is. These problems come crowding in and everything's racing, and I get to the point I just feel like I'm never gonna feel that peace and comfort again.
You might feel a little more comfortable without the ankle holster.
Oh, right. I forgot about that one. I don't know. It's just hard sometimes holding this whole thing together.
I'm sure it is.
Sort of lonely. I don't know why I'm telling you all this. I just feel like I can trust you. Can I trust you?
Yes.
I trust you to kiss me?
Resist.
I can't.
You're right. You're right.
No. Oh. No, I didn't mean
it. No, I've got those three kids in the other room. I've got this husband I gotta settle up with. It. I just feel like I know you.
I know.
Well, thanks a lot.
Look at that face, like a young cadet who just snuck a radiologist into the dorm.
What are you talking about?
Oh, don't get all stroppy. It was long before I met your mother.
What is wrong with you?
Some people are vulnerable. Their forces at a low ebb. And it's not right to take advantage of people in such a position.
Well, you're right. I behaved improperly.
Not you. Her son. You don't want to rush into these things.
What kind of thing?
You're building a house. Do you want to start with the roof? No. You start with the foundation. One brick on another brick, then the floor, then some walls, a couple of windows. Gabled something would be nice, and an oriel or two, a bit of stained glass. Then you think about the roof.
By any chance, do they have any psychiatrists in the afterworld? I mean, someone who could help you?
Let's face it, son. You need somebody. And I think this Janet has got a lot to recommend her. She's bright, capable, and above all, she's sturdy. But you've got to take it one step at a time. And all this house stuff that I've been building up to, she could be your foundation.
Do you mind?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm gonna sleep in the other room with the kids on the floor.
No, please. You sleep here, and I'll make other arrangements.
No, I can't.
Please.
You sure?
Okay.
Okay.
Good night.
Have closed their eyes, the moon has gone to sleep. Unloved, 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 Fraser. Fraser!
Good morning, sir.
What's going on? Morning.
Morning.
Toothpaste? Great. Office.
Right. Oh, dear.
Tell me something, Constable. Are we running a 5-star hotel?
No, sir.
A fly-by-night motel?
No.
Is it a drop-in center?
No, sir.
An orphanage?
No.
Perhaps then it's a bordello.
No, sir.
So in conclusion, this is not a place where travelers sleep, nor is it a daycare center. And it is most definitely not an institution where you would bring wayward women to satisfy animal needs in unmentionable underwear.
Do you mean desires, sir?
That's what I said.
So you did, yes.
Good. I'm glad we agree. I await your full report with bated breath. Dismissed. Fraser!
Oh, those kids, sir. What a hoot.
We got lucky. Prints on the shotgun match the fingers of this guy.
That's the shooter.
His name is Harvey the Nail Lopez, and he works out of Denver for some mob man.
Mob guy.
Guy. Man. Dude, gonna split a hair over this? The Nail's from Denver, and he works for Lester the Bull Rivers. Where do they dream up these names, or do they look through some big book to find them?
They got a big book. Long-term bad guy suspected in 3 homicides, hardcore pro.
What's the connection between Bradley Torrance and organized crime?
Ask her if she's the one who's looking for him.
For bail jumping, not for a major crime.
Oh, and you just happen to have a couple of hitmen trailing behind you in a car.
So what are you implying?
I suppose you didn't know that this Torrance was on the run with a bag full of mob money.
Bradley?
Bradley. Organized crime squad in Denver says that he ripped them off for a couple of mil. Say there's a contract out on him. I suppose these guys are here to fill it. Maybe with a little help.
So you think I'm working with them?
Well, they just couldn't waltz in here and get the police to help them. Now, could they?
No, Mother Teresa couldn't walk in here and get any help.
Because you can't walk, for one.
All right, excuse me. I think we should concentrate on trying to find Bradley Torrance. Now, we know that he's got two contract killers after him. There will undoubtedly be additional bounty hunters. He can't return to his motel room because the police on the street are looking for him.
Well, if there were any police on the street.
Well, what would he do in this situation?
He'd find a woman to help him.
Wait, more bounty hunters?
For days.
Oh, come on, Helen. We're just trying to help.
Like I should really believe that.
No, I shouldn't have said I was his sister, but...
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Gentlemen, Chicago PD.
We're the bounty hunters. We want Bradley Torrance.
Yeah? Well, get in line.
There! Get him! It's all over!
We're going back to Big Sky Country.
Hey!
I saw him first!
He's mine!
He belongs to me!
He's mine! I laid claim to the stake long before you boys even heard his name.
You think so?
I know so. January 13th, 1986. South Ridgeway Baptist Church, 11:35 a.m. I married this schmuck. He's mine.
Here we are. Who would have thought it would come to this?
My mother, my sister, most of my girlfriends.
Why didn't you tell me you had a wife?
You lied to your woman?
You can't build a relationship of mistrust, man.
I guess you didn't think it was important to tell us he was your husband.
You know, I don't get any help from the cops if I tell them I'm after a deadbeat husband. Especially not my own deadbeat husband. But I should have told you.
Why, you got something going with Hat Boy here?
Hey, what's it to you?
No, I'm a student of human nature.
What is a Mountie doing here anyway?
His name is Constable Benton Fraser. He first came to Chicago on the trail of the killers of his father, and for reasons that do not need explaining at this juncture, he has remained a liaison.
Liaison, right. Attached as liaison with the Canadian consulate. You know, it may be possible that your husband had a reason for leaving.
Yeah, he's a pig.
Well, apart from that, a different reason.
Right. What would that be?
I'm referring to the killers who are pursuing him. It might be that he didn't want to lead them to his family.
That takes guts.
Ha! I didn't think of that, did you? A lot of guys would have led armed men to their families. Not me. That's a crime. I'm guilty.
Hey, give the guy a chance.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He left 6 months ago.
Excuse me, excuse me. I hate to break up a love connection, but we've got the matter of an outstanding warrant. So I think I'm going to take our little friend down to the station and sort it out.
No, this is all a big mistake.
Usually is.
Wait, no, I'm serious. It was stupid.
Yeah, well, that much I can believe.
Hey, ma'am. You fart hammers pull those weapons in Chicago, you can say goodbye to them, okay?
No, listen, I was playing the horses. I wound up owing Lester Rivers around 50 grand. So he says, he says he's gonna forget the whole thing if I just do, run this little errand for him. So... What? What are you doing?
Nothing. No, I'm sorry. Please, carry on.
I thought you were gonna kiss it. He wasn't gonna kiss it, was he?
You're lucky he didn't lick it.
So anyway, I go. I pick up this package from these two very nasty-looking guys to take back to Lester, and I open the package. Did you ever see $2 million? Huh? Well, I'm looking at it. It's all green and beautiful, and I'm thinking this is the last chance I got to do anything for us, you know, for the kids. So I lie low for a few days, and then I hear this is like this contract out on me, and I figure maybe this hasn't been the best move that I ever made. So I go, I buy a couple of guns from this guy that I know, and they bust me for that. But I bail myself out, and I run.
To protect the children?
Right, to protect them, and Janet. Look, you don't know what it's like for me, you earning the money all the time, what it does to my self-respect.
Oh, so what you're saying is you're not really a deadbeat, you're just really, really stupid.
Right.
Touching, get in the car.
Look out.
Hey, Chicago PD!
didn't let him. You let him
you
get away.
You are some crackerjack.
Hey, your husband.
Excuse me. I think the question we should be asking ourselves is where did they take him? Now, judging from the amount of mud and manure under his fingernails, my guess is that
the stables.
Correct. Right? Shall we?
Yeah. You realize, of course, it's going to cost you better 50, 40, 30,
20.
Done.
Did you pay this guy?
Canadian funds. But I've walked along the red canals of Mars. I'm no kings and king niggas, poet, painters, and fathers. I've danced. Dance on the rings of Saturn. Steal your pilgrim souls, the only thing that ever mattered. Yeah, you're everywhere. Yeah, you're everywhere. Yeah, you're everywhere.
I don't know why this has to be so big. It's only a bag. I mean, you could bury a body.
Just do it, okay?
I'm giving back the money. You said if I give back the money, you're gonna let me live.
Dig!
I thought you knew where we were going. What are we gonna do now?
What the hell?
That's not
don't give me that.
That's the right in the first place.
I'll call for backup.
Vecchio, it's an emergency at the racetrack. I need backup. Don't put me on hold.
I think it's advisable that we wait for Ray.
Yeah, that strike ought to be over in a month or so.
I have no arrest authority here.
I do.
Want him dead or alive? Drop the gun.
Don't do it, Jan. They'll kill you.
That was really unselfish of you, Bradley.
Like, okay, so he's a nice guy. I'm still gonna kill him.
Thanks. Shouldn't have done that, but thanks.
Yeah, well, I did it for the kids.
Shut up! Pass me that bag. Give me that bag. Get it up here. What? Down!
Good work, Ray. I'll get the other one.
Hey, down!
Watch this one do for me, okay? It's worth $1,200.
Kiss the dirt! Kiss the dirt! Get down there! I want to see you.
Good riding.
You too.
Oh, thank you. Thank you kindly. Oh, I thought I sort of drifted to the left a little.
No, not at all. You know, actually, I was crowding you a little.
Oh, no. It's, I'm very inexperienced.
Really? Well, you have a wonderful natural aptitude.
You think so?
Yes. You ever thought of, riding trick in a rodeo?
No. Although, you know, now that you mention it, I was once involved in something that resembled trick riding on a renegade bison in the main street of Vegreville, a town that's noted for its enormous painted egg. Oh, my hat. You see, the bison.
Faster.
I can't go faster.
Thank
you.
Constable?
Lieutenant?
Glad to see you finally were able to shake that nagging flu, Ray.
No one's happier to be back at work than me, sir.
They're nice kids. I hope their father doesn't have to go to jail.
Yeah. Working out a deal to testify against Lester Rivers. Get immunity, witness protection, the whole 8 yards.
Hey,
Well, let's go.
Bradley, you know, you do something stupid like this again, and I'm going to punch a hole in your back and pull your spine through and beat you over the head with it.
That sounds fair, Janet.
Yeah. So anyway, I'm going to work out some arrangement with Bradley.
Huh.
Oh, no, nothing like that, no. I mean, he can come and stay on the weekends or something, but, you know, I've got this shed that I'm going to make into a bunkhouse, and, you know, he can stay out there. It's not like he's a great dad, because, I mean, hell, he's not even a good dad, but, you know, the kids need to see him, so, you know, what can you do? You just...
I understand.
Well, anyway, I just wanted to say, you know, thanks for all your help, and...
It was my pleasure.
Oh, you were great.
Thank you.
Wow. So, bye.
Okay. Hey, you know something? You can trust me.
Yeah, I know.
A man always feels better when he's done his duty.
Dad, when you were alone out there without Mom, did you ever feel lonely?
Oh, every second, son. Every second.
That's what I thought.
Hey, buddy, let's get somebody. I know you're a little short of cash, but I'm flush, so I'm buying. Look, it'll be all right.
High winds, northern sky will carry you away. You know you have to leave here. You wish that you could stay. It's four directions on this map, but you're only going